Hey, what's up? It's Ryan. Welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to show you how I turn this space into my woodworking shop. We're going to do a little insulating, hang some drywall, slop some mud on that drywall, watch me almost cut my hand off, and do some framing to help out the electrician. Then we're going to flip on the power. So let's get right into it. I'm not going to talk a lot. I'll let the subtitles take care of that. If you have any questions, feel free to drop them in the comments and I'll be sure to respond to you. But for now, sit back, enjoy the action, and I'll catch up with you when we get to that Sawzall incident. Yep, that's a bleeder. Lesson number one, don't try to one-hand a sawzall, especially when your other hand is below the tool. Lesson number two, keep two hands on the sawzall at all times. Lesson number three, make sure you have a first aid kit on site in case you forget lessons one and two. You might notice lessons one and two sound pretty similar. That's the whole point. Two hands on the tool. Now to sum this up.
What an idiot! Oh, what a loser! Good!
I didn't get a picture of this right after it happened. Of course, my priority was to get it bandaged up, but here's the scar 3 months later. Probably could have used a stitch or two, but I didn't get that done. And as we all know, this could have been much, much worse. So let's all use my stupidity as a reminder that things can go wrong when we're not paying attention in the shop. And now seems like a good a time as any to ask you to subscribe to this channel and hit that like button.